Tuesday the 13th of December 2016, a Virgin Australia Boeing 737-800 aircraft was being prepared to operate Flight 1393 from Adelaide, South Australia to Brisbane, Queensland. At 9:27 Central Standard Time, the graphical load instruction report was sent to the ramp staff allocated to load the aircraft. Virgin Australia used an electronic load control system, which was accessed by the leading hand on a mobile tablet device to organise the loading of the aircraft. The GLIR indicated the Brisbane-bound bags and all cargo, including seafood and four dogs, were to be loaded in the forward compartment, and the bags which would be transferred to connecting flights and the priority Brisbane bags were to be loaded in the aft compartment. While loading the aircraft, a member of the loading staff advised the leading hand that the Brisbane bags would not fit into the compartment with the cargo unless they were placed on top of the dog crates. If the bags were placed on the crates, the loading staff thought the dogs may not have had enough oxygen to breathe. To resolve this issue, the leading hand used the LCS to move 55 bags into section 31 and save the changes in the system. When the changes were made, the move mode and ramp clear mode buttons on the tablet screen grayed out and the load control status changed to LL. The loading staff proceeded to load these bags in section 31. When the leading hand refreshed the device after the bags had been moved, the status returned to normal and the leading hand presumed the changes had been accepted. At about 9:38, the load controller in Brisbane noticed an approval request in the LCS for the load to be redistributed. This request was for 55 bags, equal to about 870 kilograms, to be moved from section 21 to section 31. The LCS will allow the leading hand or load supervisor to move up to 500 kilograms of freight, provided the center of gravity moment does not change by more than 5 index units without the approval of the load controller, only if the resultant center of gravity remains within operational limits. However, as this amount exceeded the limits, the change needed to be approved by the load controller. Two indications were generated by the LCS for the leading hand, indicating the system was locked and the takeoff index was exceeded. A high priority message was also shown on the load controller's screen stating the takeoff index had exceeded the aft limit by 4.8 units. This meant the aircraft was no longer within the required center of gravity limits. In response, the LCS was locked for 7 minutes while the load controller calculated the required changes to the load and approved the changes in the LCS. The load controller calculated that moving 40 bags from section 31 of the aircraft back to section 21, or moving a number of passengers forward, would be enough to return the aircraft to balance. Because the leading hand was using the mobile application, the load controller thought they had a direct line of communication with the leading hand, so they used the inbuilt messaging system to send a message. The load controller received no response from the leading hand and amended the LCS. The flight information was then unlocked so the ground crew could continue to update the LCS. The leading hand did not receive these messages and they subsequently finalized the flight without making any changes or checking the LCS, and the final documents were released by the LCS automatically. This indicated the changes had been accepted and the aircraft had been loaded correctly. After the aircraft had departed, the leading hand was rechecking the paperwork and saw the bags had been moved in the LCS back to section 21 by load control. The leading hand then spoke to the airport movement coordinator. The AMCO attempted to contact the aircraft by radio, but received no response. The AMCO then contacted the load controller to explain what had happened. The load controller determined the aircraft was out of balance by 4.8 index units past the aft limit for takeoff, and the flight crew should be advised 40 bags, equal to 626 kilograms, were in section 31, not 21. To return the aircraft to balance, the load controller advised the AMCO that 3 passengers would have to move forward from zone D to zone B. When the flight crew rang for the departure call, the AMCO passed on this information. However, when asked to confirm they had received the information, there was no response. Flight dispatch then contacted the flight crew via satellite phone and confirmed the flight crew had received this information. The flight crew contacted the cabin supervisor with the request to move 3 passengers forward. There were no control issues during flight. The first step for users in the LCS is to subscribe and add themselves to the flight. This is undertaken to ensure the messages are received by people within the network, such as AMCOs, load controllers, freighters, and leading hands. This is not a compulsory page in the LCS and can be skipped when opening a particular flight. The leading hand had not subscribed to the system, meaning they did not receive the messages from the load controller about the aircraft being out of trim due to the movement of baggage. When the baggage was initially moved to Section 31 by the leading hand in the LCS, the system locked. This did not provide clear indications that the load distribution change needed acceptance by the load controller before proceeding with loading the aircraft. The leading hand was not sure what the load control status meant. Furthermore, as the system returned to open when they reset the system, they did not realize the changes had been made in the LCS. The load controller received an error message in the system because the number of bags moved by the leading hand meant that the aircraft was out of balance. The load controller attempted to contact the leading hand via the messaging system, but was unaware the leading hand had not subscribed to the system, so the messages were not received. The operator had two procedures for load control to notify the leading hand that changes have been made in the LCS. The dead load change ramp tolerance in the standard operating procedures for the flight management mobile application required that load control make a phone call to advise the leading hand or the AMCO that they had denied a change request through the LCS. The second procedure, which is in the controlling document used by load control for out of balance operations, required that load control communicated the requirements to the leading hand, which was normally done through the messaging system within the LCS. In this incident, the load controller used the messaging system, which was not effective as the leading hand was not subscribed to the system. Once the loading is completed, it is the leading hand's responsibility to confirm that the LDR reflects how the aircraft has been loaded. Although the leading hand did check, they did not detect the error until after the aircraft had departed. As a result of this occurrence, the aircraft operator issued two safety bulletins and updated their system functionality to ensure that only one leading hand can allocate him or herself to an aircraft at a time,